要请 TTS EC News， I'm Shen Wu-Pei. Taiwan has approved Moderna vaccines for children over six. Vaccination will probably take place on campuses. Premier Su Zhenchang says the government will respect parents' wishes.
Many people have been calling on the Tsai administration to start vaccinating the 6 to 11 age group. On the 17th, the Ministry of Health and Welfare said a meeting would be held on April 20th to approve Moderna vaccines administered as two half doses spaced 28 days apart for the age group. Vaccination will probably take place on campuses.
那原则上会是会比照之前12岁到17岁青少年施打的这种模式啊。 那么尽量以是以在校园团体来施打为原则，一定也会争取家长的同意书啊，之后才会来确定施打哈。Many
wanted to know why Taiwan chose Moderna when the U.S. gives BNT to children under 12. Education Minister Pan Wenzhong had no answer other than this was what a panel of health experts decided.
相关的疫苗等等，也都依相关专家会议及我们整个作业来施行进行，都会有一套严谨的程序啊，希望大家都能够配合来办理，同时也一定会尊重家长的意愿。
Premier Su Zhenchang, meanwhile, said the government cares very much about protecting young children, and it would respect parents' wishes.
小孩子有一些先天性的疾病，像是心脏方面有一些先天性心脏病等等，大家会担心会不会打了之后会不会有一些问题？那像是有些气喘、过敏性的体质等等，其实在这样施打疫苗之前，可能还是要担心说小孩子打了新冠肺炎疫苗，虽然不一定有心肌炎，但是有没有其他的严重不良反应？
Experts say children need to be individually assessed by doctors before getting vaccinated, and officials need to closely monitor adverse effects from vaccinations.
The CCC distributed 400,000 free rapid testing kits to high-risk cities, including Taipei, New Taipei, Taoyuan, and Hualien on the 17th.
The truck is transporting rapid screening tests to the New Taipei City Health Department. The number of confirmed cases in New Taipei City exceeded 400 in a single day on the 17th. Thus, the Central Epidemic Command Center urgently distributed 400,000 free home screening tests to Taipei, New Taipei, Taoyuan, Hualien, and other hotspot cities. Each city will receive 100,000 tests.
昨天下午已经到货3万剂，那这些3万剂的这个快筛试剂，我们会分配给这个高风险区域以及校园来作为一个防疫使用。The
local epidemic is severe, and the number of confirmed cases has exceeded 1,000 for four consecutive days. Many people have rushed to buy at-home tests, but they are difficult to find. CECC Commander Chen Shizhong said in the Legislative Yuan that the real name system for rapid screening tests will be available as soon as early May. The plan is for each person to buy up to 5 tests. The price is expected to be NT$100.
你的快筛剂可能压到一剂变成100块吗？
我们尽量努力，有这个可能性。
Additionally, the Taiwan Food and Drug Administration approved the Moderna vaccine for emergency use authorization for 6 to 11-year-old children. Kids' dose will be half of adults. However, some KMT legislators are worried about the side effects and hope that Taiwanese children could be vaccinated with the Pfizer vaccine like in the U.S. Many parents also protested on the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Health and Welfare's Facebook pages.
未来的确是有可能 BNT 可以开放使用给6到11岁的孩子。
我实在不敢期望，因为这里面来来去去已经2个多月了哈。部长，因为每次都有一些新的小的问题哈，这样的，我们尽量就是说不要让这些小的问题干扰到整体的采购的程序啊。但是事实上，这个合约不太容易谈。Chen
said that an expert meeting will be held on the 20th to discuss whether the Moderna vaccine shot will be started for children. He emphasized that the government is not forcing children to get the vaccine. Parents can also consult doctors after obtaining consent forms. A draft contract has been sent to Pfizer to procure the children's vaccine, but the government has not received a reply yet.
The St. Hayes County, the Yunlin County Wedding Banquet Cluster is now at its sixth. The Health Bureau says 107 people have been asked to be quarantined.
A truck disinfects the streets of Taishi after six new cases were confirmed in Yunlin County on the 17th. Three of the cases were connected to the Mai Liao wedding banquet, including a 60-something farmer and his daughter and a family member that lives with them.
一直到目前都还在持续的在我们在追踪当中，但是也陆续都有发生案例。到4月17号呢，总共有三例，两例是本身有参加这个喜宴的，那另外一例呢是延伸到他的同住家人。
The banquet took place on April 10th, and the first case from the cluster, a 30-something woman who lives in Huwei, was reported on April 14th. Two more cases were reported on the 16th and three more on the 17th for a total of six so far.
我们总共框列了有107个需要做居家隔离的，那107个在本县里的是有55位，那在外县市的是52位，那在我们本县市框列的这个55位的当中呢，就已经有这个本身有参加喜宴就有5位，那将近10%的一个几率。
The Bureau says the places the six people frequent are mostly in Huwei, Mai Liao, and Taishi, and the places they recently visited have all been disinfected. Local officials say anyone that attended the wedding on the 10th should get tested immediately if they start developing symptoms like cough or sore throat.
台北市立mayor and deputy mayor are currently self-quarantined at home. Mayor 柯文哲 said,He's worried as the number of people quarantined increases, social institutions may be paralyzed as a result.
People exercising outdoors should be naturally more careful as the epidemic spreads. A new Taipei man went out to play basketball with friends even after he was diagnosed with the virus. He kept posting updates on Instagram stories during the entire time. Some netizens couldn't stand the violation and took screenshots to report the case. Now,The new Taipei Health Department has decided to impose heavy penalties.
他是我们居家照护的对象，所以他必须要在家中一人一室做隔离。他已经是确诊者，明明知道自己是确诊，还私自外出，而且还公然PO网，严重挑战公权力。所以我们决定在考量种种情况之下，要重罚他150万元。
This man from New Taipei Sansha received a positive PCR test on April 14. He was supposed to be quarantined at home, but did not comply with epidemic prevention regulations.He did not shy away from his time outside playing basketball and shopping, as he posted on his Instagram feed. Due to the serious violations, the health department forcibly transferred him to a centralized quarantine center and fined him 1.5 million NT dollars. Taipei City, which is also severely affected by the epidemic, launched a pilot home care program on April 18th.Mayor Ke Wenze and Deputy Mayor Huang Sanshen are currently in quarantine at home because they came in contact with a confirmed case. They are holding epidemic prevention meetings by video conference.
我都可以非常清楚，这个礼拜全台大乱。你想想看哦，现在六万人被居家隔离，你为了照顾这六万人，你要花多少力气？
More and more people are being quarantined as the number of confirmed cases continues to rise.Mayor Ke worries that social institutions may be paralyzed as a result.
By Saturn, Mazu Pilgrimage is expecting attendance of around 90,000. Proof of three vaccine doses will be required to register and attend.
Mazu devotees wait in line to register at Bai Shatun Gongtian Temple. One devotee came all the way from Jiayi to ask for blessings for her 90-something grandma. She waited in line for 6 days to get the first stick of incense.
我没有带拿妈祖布，但是我都提示妈祖婆说，我可不可以代替她背着背伤，然后帮她走？对，
走完全程。
走完全程。
Turnout for the incense offering event is expected to be around 90,000. The temple says registration won't close until May 16th. Proof of three vaccine doses is required to register and attend. Devotees are also allowed to register for other people.
Because there are 3G problems, it should not be as we said, 9,000 people.还是餐前为主啦，没有打三剂的，我们今年就暂时不要去进香。
The temple says devotees won't be allowed to stay overnight at the temple this year due to the epidemic, and it hopes everyone can take care of their own health. The pilgrimage will kick off on May 20th and arrive in Beigang on the 22nd. As the route is decided by the temple's Matsu sculpture, managing the event will be a huge challenge.
Now with some top stories from around the world. Thousands of people gathered in Tokyo to protest against Japan's nuclear policy, including its plan to release treated water from the Kyushu nuclear power plant into the ocean. Tunisia will work with other countries that have offered to help it to prevent environmental damage after a merchant ship carrying up to 1,000 tons of oil sank in Tunisian waters. Russia said its forces had almost completely seized the port of town Mariupol. However, Ukrainian soldiers said the city still has not fallen. A snake was found on Taiwan Railway's Zicheng Limited Express from Miaoli to Hualien.
A snake about 1 meter long climbed on the handrail of the train carriage, frightening passengers. The snake was discovered at 8:19 a.m. on the 18th on Taiwan Railway's Zicheng Limited Express number 272 from Miaoli to Hualien. It was found in a 12th train compartment after passing Reifang Station. The snake was found climbing on the luggage rack, and the train conductor was quickly notified. Taiwan Railways evacuated passengers to another carriage and notified the Yilan Fire Bureau. When the train stopped at Yilan Station, firefighters boarded the train to remove the snake. Firefighters confirmed the snake was a python and was not poisonous. The snake was immediately caught and placed in the cage. People suspected that it was a pet snake because it was not aggressive. According to Article 46 of Taiwan Railway's passenger transport contract, passengers are not allowed to bring snakes, birds, or aggressive pets on board. Otherwise, a fine of 1,500 to 7,500 NT dollars can be imposed in accordance with the Railway Act. Taiwan Railway is currently still investigating where the snake came from.
Thank you for watching PTS Asia News, and see you next time.